We enjoyed mostly clear blue skies and sunshine today with light winds. Top temperatures 2 to 4 degrees warmer than average. Reaching a top of 21 in Kellyville and Parramatta, 17 in Terry Hills, 20 in the city and 18 in Cronulla. Parts of southeast New South Wales have experienced their coldest five-day run of mornings in at least 5 years, thanks to high pressure and a very dry air mass, including Braidwood averaging minus 5 degrees, Young, Nerriga and Bombala averaging minus 3, minus 2 in Bega and Moss. But if you think that's cold, a weather station at Concordia Research Station in Antarctica may have just registered the world's lowest temperature in 6 years today, dropping to an icy minus 82.9 degrees. Back home, daytime temperatures were 2 to 7 degrees above average, reaching 16 in Albury, Batemans Bay, Wagga Wagga and Bathurst, 18 the top in Mudgee and Newcastle. Tomorrow, a cold front and trough will cross southern WA, causing showers and gusty winds, while a high will bring mostly dry conditions across New South Wales. Brisbane will be fine tomorrow, heading for 22 degrees, partly cloudy and 16 in Canberra, staying fine with a top of 15 on the way for Melbourne. Another mostly sunny day for New South Wales tomorrow, heading for 19 in Bega, Batemans Bay and Dubbo, 21 for Wollongong, Newcastle and Narrabri. And there is a hazardous surf warning along the Macquarie, Hunter, Sydney and Illawarra coasts. After some patchy fog and frost in our outer west, Sydney will be sunny tomorrow with light winds. Temperatures 4 to 5 degrees warmer than average, heading for tops of 21 to 22 degrees right across our west, including Penrith, Liverpool and Campbelltown, 19 on the way for Terry Hills and Cronulla, 21 for the city. Let's take a look ahead and we can look forward to blue skies and sunshine for the next 7 days. Top temperatures ranging from 20 to 23 degrees, that is 4 to 7 degrees above average, nights ranging from 8 to 11 degrees. In our west, some very spring-like temperatures ahead under sunny skies, reaching a top of 22 on Thursday, 24 on Friday, then 23 Saturday. But take a look at Sunday, 25 degrees. That is the warmest day for the week, 7 degrees above average. Still some cool nights though, ranging from 3 to 7 degrees, Pete.
Peaked at 9 degrees here at Falls. Melbourne was cloudy early on, which kept it mild overnight. The city only got down to 10 degrees. Then it cleared up beautifully for a top of 15. Dropped to zero here this morning, and it was chilly through most of northern Victoria. Wodonga also dipped to zero and bounced back under sunny skies to reach 17. Elsewhere, maximums generally ranged from 12 to 15. A high pressure system is moving across Victoria, bringing the settled conditions and also clearing skies as it heads further east. It's moving at a very leisurely pace, so we can expect another calm day tomorrow and even more winter sunshine. Northerly winds will strengthen on Thursday as an approaching trough makes its way across the Bight, and the associated showers are expected over western districts later in the day, and they'll extend across the rest of the state on Friday. Looking elsewhere for tomorrow, Brisbane is heading for 22 degrees, sunny and 21 in Sydney. It'll drop to minus 2 in Canberra overnight before a top of 16. 16 in Hobart as well. Adelaide should go one higher, 17 under blue skies. And for Perth, rain and possible storms developing from tonight. Back home, most of central and eastern Victoria is under a frost warning, with temperatures set to drop to 3 degrees and below. Here at Falls Creek, it's going to be sunny again with a top of 6 degrees. Most other places are heading for the low to mid-teens. For Melbourne, Ferny Creek will be the coldest at both ends of the day, with a low of 1 and a top of 10 degrees. Otherwise, dropping to 4 or 5 around most suburbs and then climbing to 14 or 15. Geelong should reach 15 degrees from a low of 5. In the city, down to 6 overnight, then calm and partly cloudy tomorrow, top of 15. 16 on Thursday, but winds becoming gusty in the afternoon. 17 on Friday, up to 6 millimetres of showers, most likely in the morning and windy again. Mostly sunny and 17 on Saturday, then nudging 20 on Sunday, which is very warm for this time of the year. 17 Monday with late showers and a shower or two on Tuesday. Thanks to Visit Victoria, we'll be here again at Falls Creek tomorrow. And if you can, midweek is the perfect time to head to the snow peak.
Oh, we certainly are, Melissa. Plenty of cool, dry air over southeast Queensland and lots of single-digit temperatures overnight. The next few days, we're going to see quite a few cold mornings, but some nice days. Wait till you see what's forecast for the last few days of July. We'll get to that in a moment. First up, temperatures across your backyard as we check the flyover over southeast Queensland. And temperatures today, well, 17 degrees, the max in Toowoomba. 23 was the high today, and that was at Redcliffe, the Gold Coast, Sunshine Coast hitting 21. The weather map, a cold cold front and a trough crossing southern WA will cause showers and gusty winds. A large high-pressure system in the east delivering showers to the Queensland coast. Capitals, a wet day in Perth, sunny for Adelaide, cloudy in Hobart, early frost for Canberra, sunny in Sydney and Darwin. Queensland, cloudy and wet for Cairns, few showers in Townsville, windy with possible showers in Mackay, a little bit of cloud and windy for Gladstone and Rocky, partly cloudy and moderate southeasterlies around Bundy and Maryborough, sunny and a little windy inland for Mount Isa and Longreach. For the southeast, a partly cloudy day, moderate southeasterly winds, cool overnight, while daytime temperatures in the low 20s, a maximum of 23 forecast for Ipswich. Moreton Bay, the southeasterlies, 15 to 20 knots, they're gradually easing, the sea's up to a metre and a half. Brizzy, partly cloudy, a low of 12 and a high of 22. Your week ahead, early fog patches Thursday, fine Friday, a sunny weekend with light winds and 25 for Saturday. Ipswich, early fog Thursday, fine Friday and 24, sunny weekend. Look at those temps, up to 26 degrees for Sunday. For the Goldie, a little cloud Thursday, mostly sunny Friday, a beautiful weekend with warmer temperatures and light winds. And on the Sunshine Coast, chance of a shower Thursday, then partly cloudy Friday. Looking at partly cloudy skies over the weekend and some slightly warmer temperatures with light winds up to about 24 degrees on Saturday. So some chilly mornings to wrap up July, but some nice warmer days heading our way, guys.
Well, it's only 10 degrees as the chill sets in over Adelaide tonight. Certainly feeling crisp right now. We've seen clear skies, but we did manage to make it to 17 degrees earlier on in the city when the cloud cover cleared and let that sunshine through across the suburbs. We certainly saw that in the afternoon at Elizabeth too, with a top of 17 degrees. It took a little bit longer for that cloud cover to clear out through the southern suburbs, but we did make 15 degrees at Noarlunga. A clearing trend in our north today too, with temperatures warming to 18 at Port Augusta and Port Pirie. Meantime, the cloud cover lingered further south, so Mount Gambier only made 14 and Narracourt 13 degrees, but still pretty overcast around there. On the charts, you can see a high-pressure system hanging out over Victoria. That's filtering inland air over us tomorrow and delivering the clear, sunny conditions in store. Interstate, it is still looking cool through the southeast corner of the country. Melbourne 15 tomorrow, Canberra 16, but Sydney looking a bit sunnier with 21 in store. But have a look at all that sunshine expected through SA tomorrow. There won't be too many complaints about that, I don't think. Clear skies and 21 for Port Augusta, a fresh 16 at Maitland. Port Lincoln is shaping up pretty nicely with a sunny 18 on the way. Nuriutpa, a clear 16, and Victor Harbour soaking up a sunny 17 degrees tomorrow. Of course, with the clear skies, we also see the cold nights. And so we have a frost warning in place for the Riverland, with early morning temperatures falling below zero once again overnight tonight. It should be pretty calm on metro waters, though, with north to northeasterlies about 10 knots and seas below a metre. And how about a lovely dose of winter sun for our suburbs tomorrow? A midweek treat, temperatures just ever so slightly edging upwards, 17 degrees for Marion and Mount Barker, 16 degrees for Golden Grove. We've got dry skies in the city with, again, 17 degrees in store. And then from there, we take another little step up with temperatures on Thursday. If we're lucky, we'll get up to around 18 degrees. But in the afternoon, we do have a front arriving, and that will probably bring some showers from the afternoon and into the nighttime. So showers remaining potentially on Friday morning, but clearing out in time for the weekend, where we should get another good dose of sun.
Perth has avoided the worst of the wet weather today, while the southwest copped a drenching 110 millimetres landing on Vass, most of that falling in just 90 minutes, triggering a severe weather warning. So far, the city has recorded just 0.6 millimetres in the gauge. Perth reached a top temperature today of 17, following our overnight low of 9. Right now, it's 15 degrees, but feels colder. Checking the charts now, you can see that strong cold front is right now moving east, but tomorrow in its wake we'll continue to have some onshore showers associated with the system for the next few days. Across the map tomorrow, a wet Wednesday for Cairns, reaching 25, 22 in Brisbane, 21 the top in Sydney, as well as sunshine in Adelaide. Back home tomorrow, 6 to 20 millimetres forecast to fall. Small hail is even possible for Perth. The mercury should climb to a top of 15 degrees after the overnight low of 9. Unfolding the full forecast now, we are going to reach a top of 17 on Thursday. Only 3 mils in the gauge then. The wet weather will hang around into the weekend before it clears up ever so slightly on Monday, reaching 19, and then we should crack 21 next week. But in the meantime, it might be best to rug up, Mon.